We crown a champion tonight here at Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara for the College Football Playoff National Championship game, as it's the USC Trojans taking on the Florida Gators.
My bad.
One game to decide it all.
I just be pushing. This time I right here, look.
National championship, and off we go from Levi's Stadium.
Come on, let's go.
This is fielded at the goal line.
I'm the Florida Gators in here.
And a nice job there as he gets it just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34.
I think this is really about...
He's 1-0 as a collegiate starter, but now the pressure rises as the Gators come up first and 10. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Got his man. It's the All-American Isaiah Streets. And they're going to have this across midfield and
go Gators.
45. 23 yards, the final tally. Charles, the success that this quarterback had in the semifinal, how does it translate here?
Well, it certainly helps his mindset because he has to have a lot of confidence going into this one since he did it so well in the semifinals. I do think we'll see a similar kind of offense. They'll find places for him to take his shots, and especially you have to when you've got a weapon like Streets on the outside.
There's a ball thrown right side and complete, and he will score. Touchdown, Florida. Chris Arnold. 43 yards. And the Gators have taken the early lead.
I'm playing a franchise.
They didn't get the wake-up call before the game. They got it right now. Two plays already in the end zone.
I think of it in boxing terms. Whether it's a big shot with your first one or
so I'm playing for the Gators. And then when I finish, I'm supposed to get drafted into the NFL. You know what I'm saying? So it's my first time doing it. And I played last night.
So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off.
Capture this memory right here.
This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a
touchback,
and it comes out to the 25-yard line.
Yeah.
Here's first and 10 for the Trojans.
My kid told me to play this, and
operating from the gun.
Pick them off. Let's go. Y'all see that? Hot hands, baby.
First week of the preseason, probably not the pass. The impression that the rookie wants to leave right there.
Yeah, no problem about
I can get
it,
though.
That's not what you want to do to try and pressure new coaches.
I be playing mad so much now, man.
And most importantly,
I'm not really even
yourself.
I was playing Call of Duty, Grand Theft Auto.
Make sure you take care of
the last month or two I've been playing.
Well, now he's got out of the way. Hopefully he can just settle in.
I want to play now. I'll go back.
On play action, no throw.
Under
a heavy rush, and down he goes.
I bet, man. PCD now.
Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
I just don't really know about who's playing.
You figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you. And you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
Now the throw on third down, knocked away and incomplete.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
And that one's not going to get there. Not enough juice, an ambitious effort, but it's well short. And this score will stay right where it is.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
I know I ain't. I'm going to pick this shit up.
The SC offense about set to take over here. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last
one. To add Mexico.
See what happens. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
So they move from 136 over to the other as they come up on first down. From the gun, Morse. And he's got his man on the out route.
All right, I sent you one.
Offense.
So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. On second down, Darby. And once again, not much running room, if any at all. No gain on that one as it brings up the third and 10. For USC, such a storied program. 11 times they've been crowned national champions, beginning with the earliest way back in 1928, all the way until their most recent title in 2004. Moores gets set to pass. Looking left sideline, it's complete. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. It's his first catch, and it'll be good for 15 at a first down.
They basically let your ass win, though. I ain't gonna lie.
Throwing on first down. Morse, nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And this is picked up by the defense. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. He didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
A quick burst.
You're a gator, you're not a hater.
A pretty decent game.
The last run got six.
Remember that kid.
Now second and four. It's Armstrong on the carry. And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of three. And guess what? It brings up third down. That's some good tackling there to keep him short of that yellow line.
Yeah, defensively, all I'm thinking is that on that play, get me to third down. Get me into a position where I can make one more play to get my defense off the field.
And he's going to get to the 31, enough for the first down.
On third and one, it seems natural to just turn and hand it to the biggest guy you have in the backfield. But usually, he's not the primary runner. So for the defense, they're often keying on the running back because he's the guy who gets the ball more often, and the fullback is the blocker. When he ends up carrying the football, that's a heck of a tendency breaker. And now you're just trying to jump on his back and hold on.
He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And down to the 19-yard line. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down. For Charles in the past, a lot of people called this offense one-dimensional.
I think you did.
Well,
I think it was you.
I'll be honest, I did. I think the fan base is hoping with this young rookie that they can put some wrinkles in this offense like we just saw.
I think you're exactly right, because we did have that discussion that what we've seen in the past from them, they needed to broaden, and they have done it here. Look at what he's bringing to their offense, and now as a defensive coordinator, you've got some extra work to do to prepare for.
And he will score. Touchdown, Florida. From 10 yards out. And the Gators push that lead out a bit further.
Great field position has to be one of the best friends an offense can have. When you don't have very far to go, you should cash it in with points.
This time, the extra point up and good. And the lead now stands at 13. Here's Florida now after the touchdown, back out to kick it off. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Trojan offense ready to get their next drive started. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. Two drives, two turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath. First, do no harm. And right now, they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaking me for a doctor, though. But thank you, Dr. Davis. USC gets set here, first and 10. They'll run it with Irons. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Still a few inches short of a first down as they come up now on second down. 13-0 is the score after one on EA Sports. So not quite a first down just yet as they come up on second and less than a yard. Off play action. Morse. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. A first down there on a pickup of 25.
You know I'm going to lean towards the defender, right? You know I'm going to do that.
I know.
That's a tough situation for him as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was not streaking towards him. Have no arc on it. He's got to find a way to get his head around and make the play in the football.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Another example right there how this defense really is winning the entire game at the point of attack.
Yeah, right there at the line of scrimmage because they are dominating it. It allows their interior guys to get upfield and spill into the backfield. So how are you going to combat that? You know, because they bring in your tight end, keep him in, your running backs, they have to step forward. Bottom line, your offensive line has to block them first to give yourself a chance.
Throwing on third and long. Morse. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line.
I love the intelligence the defense just showed there. Read their keys, saw the screen developing, ran to it, and smothered it. What a third down stop by them.
And this one looks good. It is good. Right down the pipe. And they will indeed get on the board here, but still trailing. It's now 13-3.
These kickers now, it's like we take them for granted. Kicks like that used to be such a big deal, and now you just expect them to make it.
Yeah, you're exactly right, and we shouldn't take them for granted. But I have a theory about it. You want to hear it?
Yeah.
They are more athletic now than ever before. Talk about kickers. Trace their backgrounds, trace their histories. You'll find that they were big-time athletes all along, but their kicking was so prevalent that we made them specialists. Yeah,
and now those 50-plus yarders seem easy for some reason.
The Gator offense about ready to get this next drive started. Charles, we talked in the semifinal about Isaiah Street's brother, Ezekiel, lost due to leukemia exactly 1 year ago today. But since then, Isaiah's been active in trying to help those who are going through the same struggles his brother went through. He formed a real bond, in fact, over the summer with one of them, 11-year-old cancer patient Emily Atwood of Centerville, Texas. And we're told that Emily and her father, Todd, made the two-hour drive up to Arlington a week ago to watch their semifinal victory. Blitz coming and down he goes.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way, and what else do you have to look?
And that's caught inside the 30. And a huge play that time. 62 yards. If you were with us for the semifinal, we told the story. I mean, this is a quarterback who was heavily recruited out of high school 4 years ago on signing day. Had all the hats in front of him. People weren't sure where he was going to go. So many different offers. And he will score. Touchdown, Florida. Isaiah Streets with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Gators push that lead out a bit further. He's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, two touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
Extra point splits the uprights. And that'll make this a three-score game now. The lead moves to 17. Here's Florida now after the touchdown, back out to kick it off. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The SC offense about set to take over here. Well, it's been very much a slow start for them. Three drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is one. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts. Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. And what a big-time play there. 44 yards. Well, they know they've got a good starter. Now the guy coming in to spell him shows he can run it pretty good as well.
And I think he appreciates the starter, wearing people down, tiring them out a little bit. He took full advantage, didn't he? Came in with fresh legs and carried the ball.
2 yards that time, a stark contrast from the big chunk on the previous play.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up, because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
To throw is Moores. And his throw is incomplete.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
And a pretty little juke move there on a nice game. Well, the screen gets seven, but it's not enough, and it'll be fourth down.
They dialed up the screen pass on third down, and for a second, it looked like it was all going to come together, and they had a chance to pick up a first down, but the defense got there and finished it off.
And his kick is right there. It's good, and high fives for that one as that drive ends in three. So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know that they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
Now the Trojans ready to kick it off following their made field goal. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Ready to begin their next drive. Here's the Florida offense. Time for a final kneel down or a safe run, and then they can head to the locker room with a lead.
Yeah, or they can even run a screen. You know, something that feels somewhat safe that might actually pop and turn into a big play. Hello? That's what you usually run in this situation.
Or go four verticals. Hello? Because why not?
Because you're feeling it, right? You're just feeling it.
This sure would be one heck of a story as the Gators sit just two quarters away from a national title.
Can't find my damn hoodie.
Hey, you need to play better in the second half, all right?
What?
Just give me the ball, all right? Let me do my thing.
I agree.
Got it.
Hey, you know how much this means to me, right?
Of course I do.
Then make it happen.
Okay, man. Just one half remains in the college football season as we begin the second half of this national championship game. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line.
Yeah. I went to work not the day before.
The Trojan offense ready to get their next drive started. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is. Right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there. And this is a I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. And not much.
And what about that?
Up to the 29. Now third down is looming. A pickup of two on first down and just 1 yard there.
That didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw
the
listen,
when they used to tell me about signature, I thought it was a case of
see ball, get ball. Now Moores. And that is
rehabilitation.
Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up. So coming up empty here to start the third quarter. Already two scores down. Got to be careful.
I didn't notice, though, that the captain of the defense patted the quarterback on the helmet on his way out, pretty much letting him know, we know the pressure's on us. We're going to go out there and try and hold serve for you while you figure it out over here on the sidelines.
On is the punt team now as this one sent away.
Yeah. They got one.
Taking it about the 16.
Over there.
Well, it wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially given 15. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs.
Off of Blandon and, because I went over there.
The Gator offense about ready to get this next drive started. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. They've got to like their position. They lead this championship game, two quarters to play. What's the course of action in the second half?
I think you continue to show your quarterback that you've got faith in him. Continue to run the offense the way you did in the first half. Continue to give him opportunities. But behind his back, head coach is telling the offensive play caller, if you see any moments where it feels too big for him, be ready to dial this game plan back.
And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. He got 29 yards that time. First and 10, Florida. They'll look to throw. Quick slant caught by Streets. But he doesn't quite make it, taking it Two choke plays in a row. The last one was over 20 yards, and so is this one. The Gators now with a first and goal. They'll try to run now with Jennings. And he is in. Touchdown, Gators. Taking it in from a yard out. And the Gators push that lead out a bit further. Sometimes a group that gets overlooked, certainly, the offensive line. Right there, they really helped with that score.
Didn't they tell us in our meeting that when we score touchdowns, running the ball, that means the offensive line actually scored first by moving people back beyond the end zone. We saw evidence of that on that play.
Extra point right down the middle. And a lead now to three touchdowns at 21.
Robert McCray.
Here's Florida now after the touchdown, back out to kick it off. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line.
So, I know they had to order the medicine.
The SC offense about set to take over here. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax.
Oh, they said y'all was working. I talked to someone yesterday.
That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
Yeah, because I already did this, the sleep study. They said I got sleep apnea. So, I talked to someone yesterday.
And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41.
And he said that in order for y'all to
a loss of a full 3 yards on first
down. And my daughter had to send a referral in for the medicine. And then that way, if not, I have to come back in and see y'all doctor.
Looking to throw on second down. It's Robbins.
I guess they use some medicine to see what's the difference. I guess, you know what I'm saying, because I didn't sleep that many hours.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
I don't know. I mean, that's what I heard. I don't know.
Back to throw.
I'm just trying to get word.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
Looks like another empty possession here, partner, and I don't think with three scores down in the third quarter, they can truly afford any more the rest of the way.
No, especially the way their offense is sputtering. I think you're exactly right. They got to find some answers quickly. And a nice special teams job here. This is going to be down inside the 10 at the 7-yard line.
absolutely love the flexibility of these punters. Their leg drive, able to get it way up in the air, and that allows their punt team to get down there and down it inside the 10 because they've had some time.
Now a throw right side taken in here to start this drive. And all the way down to the 40-yard line. A big play there. 53 yards. I know it's tough to make tackles in the open field, but that one hurts because he got a little bit extra after the missed tackle.
Receivers are coached so well, they have to break at least one tackle after the catch. He did that on that play.
That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And he will score. Touchdown, Florida. Ray Ray O'Neal, 40 yards. And the Gators push that lead out a bit further. There you go, Charles. Apparently all she had to do was ask. How about that? His fourth touchdown pass in this championship game.
Give her credit for asking. Give him credit for living up to it. And I bet they're both relieved that there won't be another game. She might ask for 8 touchdown passes in that one.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback.
He gave it
comes out to the 25-yard line.
I get a surgery. So I don't know what that's about. I tell him I ain't trying.
The Trojan offense ready to get their next drive started. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game. They're being blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough because we always said that it'd be a team game and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off right around the 43. The Gators now with a 1st and 10. Looking to throw. And he is going to be taken down. And that should be the final play of this 3rd quarter. 3 quarters in the books. Back now here on EA Sports. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number 4. Now they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's 2nd and 21. They'll drop the throw. This one complete to Streets. Breaks the tackle. He's got room to run. And finally down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to 7. It's a game of 35. Boy, another big play late here for an offense, Charles. It certainly has had its fair share of big plays.
Coverage has been a problem all game long. I can say that going along with that has been confidence. Because even if they had the right coverage.
And that's going to be caught. Touchdown, Florida. Isaiah Streets there to make the grab as his guys continue to put this one out of reach. He was on point throwing the ball right there. He had the big play to get him down close, and then he delivers a touchdown pass on 1st and goal.
And you mentioned the big play that got him down close. I think that big play left him reeling a little bit. They didn't recover from it. And you know, they always talk about having to have a short memory on defense after a big play against you. Looks like their memory was a little too long there.
0-4, 5-8-4.
This is fielded a couple yards deep.
Because I had him fax over.
And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he's simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. The SC offense about set to take over here. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that out the window?
Yeah, because the doctor had written
me. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go,
I did an in-lab, I had him fix over again.
You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
To my primary
doctor. How they attack him here.
I'm doing the doctor's job.
Time tonight, he's intercepted. He's picked off at his own 46.
certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now three interceptions in this ballgame.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
Everyone, Peyton Manning, who's 28 his rookie year. How things turn out for him?
I think okay. He's a guy in all the commercials now.
Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
They have the nice cushion. They just want to pour it on right now, still throwing the football.
And I know my background says, why do you need to do this? Just go ahead and run out the clock and get a win. But as many people pointed out to me, it's a video game, man. Go ahead and put the numbers up. Sportsmanship, not an issue.
Exercise those fingers.
All right, thank you.
Delay of game, yeah, no, offense.
I say.
And that'll set them back five.
Come on, man. Let's go.
Still first down.
Yes, ma'am.
Now they need 15 yards on this series after the delay of game. First and 15. They'll set up a throw. Open man here, Streets. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. It's a solid pickup of 11, and it's second down. Second and 4. Well, that's a play that Isaiah Streets made time after time this fall on Saturday afternoon. And you got to think, as this championship game continues to unfold, they have to find some way to slow him down. Double team, just anything to disrupt him, because he has a knack for getting open and making big plays. Now here's Armstrong. And he is in. Touchdown, Gators. A 5-yard touchdown run as his guys continue to pour it on.
There's no doubt in my mind.
And do you hear that? Do you hear the...
It's not scales, right? I don't hear scales. Do I actually hear a tune being warbled?
I think the fat lady's humming.
Yeah, she's doing more than humming. She's belting it out right now.
She's going. She's full bore.
Yeah, this thing is flat out finished.
Point after, right down the middle. And the lead will swell by one more. Here's Florida now after the touchdown. Back out to kick it off. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Trojan offense ready to get their next drive started. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, and finally we kept having a rough patch. He said, but you got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Second and 2. His throw incomplete. Just nothing there again. He's been sacked multiple times. We've seen the interceptions, of course. He's really been through the ringer, hasn't he?
And what we've seen is a defense that's well coordinated. The front and the back really in sync. The front putting on the pressure. The backside being ball hawks and picking passes off.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
He gets this away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. Ready to begin their next drive. Here's the Florida offense. They'll come out throwing here on first down. And Charles, at this point, it's all about game management. See this one out, and you're national champions.
I think if you go back to the Marcus Washington injury and you ask the coaching staff, what percent chance do you think you have of winning 2 games and winning the national title? I'd say they capped it at, what, 15-20%?
That's caught inside the 20. And he takes it in for a Gator touchdown. He has really settled in throwing the football, and that touchdown here in the fourth quarter gives him a pretty comfortable cushion.
He may be a rookie, but he's playing like fourth quarter, and the QBing is easy. How about this guy? Youngster, not worried about anything, just cutting it loose and having fun.
Yes, I'm out.
The try here for the extra point.
All right, can I get you to fax over my end labs to the other doctor?
As they just add on to their big lead.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. 904-292-9264. Now they know who. Once they see my name, they know who it is.
Here's Florida now after the touchdown, back out to kick it off.
All right, thank you, man.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The SC offense about set to take over here. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him. All right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But, hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. He's picked off at his own 46. Well, you just kind of feel for him right now. Four interceptions, and you can almost see through his face mask. There's a lot going on in between the ears.
There certainly is, and probably way too much, because now he's probably doubting himself a little bit, wondering what adjustments he has to make. But here's what he needs to do. Get through this game. Go to the press conference. Meet it head on and show your teammates you're ready to shoulder what happened today, and you'll be ready for the next game.
And if he can do that as a rookie, that's a great sign of maturity. First and 10, Florida. Now it looks like he'll throw here. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. They're still throwing the football here, and obviously the incompletion stops the clock. That's a bad thing.
Feels to me like they're just keeping them honest on defense, because you know they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and try and stop any type of running play. Short little passes may work in exchange of running plays.
I did the sneak test.
Keep them moving.
I guess you're right. If they can get some first downs, just as good as running the football. 11 yards there, first down.
Talking about him just getting
him. He's certainly been a huge factor in this one. He's got the two touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him? Double and triple and do what you have to do. But sometimes they get locked into such a groove and such a connection, it doesn't matter how many guys are in his area.
He certainly looks to be in that groove right now. The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Jennings. And he is in. Touchdown, Gators. DeMarcus Jennings. His second touchdown of the night as his guys continue to put this one out of reach.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. The extra point splits the uprights, and that will extend this big lead. Here's Florida now after the touchdown, back out to kick it off. This is fielded a couple yards deep.
Okay.
And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. The Trojan offense ready to get their next drive started. Let's just be frank. They're playing
That's all we're waiting on.
That's all that's left because victory, not a chance now.
So that way I can get
and I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now, and if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. So how about this? Behind a QB who had never taken a snap in an NCAA football game until just 9 days ago, for the first time since 2008, the Florida Gators are your national champions.
Ladies and gentlemen, please turn your attention to the podium at midfield for the presentation of the College Football Playoff National Championship Trophy as we present your College Football National Champion, the Florida Gators.
0-6-8-7.
Jack Ford. Talk about a long shot. And as a man who's known as the quarterback whisperer, and I suggest you trademark that, by the way, how are you feeling about your quarterback right now?
I tell you, this kid's amazing. He worked around the clock to prepare for this game. I never seen anything like it. And I am so proud of what he's done, and under this kind of pressure. Hope all you NFL scouts out there are paying attention, because this kid's special.
Come on.
You deserve it, son. Congratulations.
Coach, this is you. This is great. Thank you.
A perfect end to a too short season. You're leaving here a champion.
I it's better than I ever thought it would feel. I can't even describe it, really. It's just to be up on this stage, celebrating with these guys. It's perfect. It's just perfect.
It is a perfect end, but it seems like you put up a pretty good case that it shouldn't be today. How do you feel about that?
I think I gave myself a shot. If the NFL comes calling, I'll pick up the phone. But this guy over here, this guy, the trophy man.
Absolutely. Isaiah Streets, we are all aware of the loss of your brother and what it took to be here today. But can you tell us, in this moment, how you're feeling right now?
It's a lot, lots of feelings, Taylor. I made a promise to my brother that I was gonna bring. You know, none of this would have been possible without this man right here. This dude came into an impossible situation. He's got heart. Love you, man.
Hey, I love you, man.
See? This was for you, baby!
Yeah!
This was for you!
Yeah!
Let's go!
A lot of emotions out on the field tonight. This is what football is all about. About getting hit and getting back up. And as you can see in a season, it was characterized by overcoming. These guys did just that and won a national championship. Back to you guys.
Right. Right. Okay, yeah, thank you. Thank you. Yeah, he's actually right here. Okay, hang on.
Hello?
Hey, how's it going? It's Emily's dad. Look, I know that you got a lot on your plate, and I don't want to take up too much of your time, but I did want to tell you that Emily's out of her surgery, and she is doing great. She got to see the game and everything. You have made a fan for life in her.
Thank you so much for the kind words. Please, have Emily stay in touch.
I will. Thank you. All right, bye.
And take care.
See you, baby.
College football season's wrapped up and the draft is 2 months away.
Today, we kick off the NFL Scouting Combine. Over the next 7 days, more than 300 college prospects will run, jump, catch, and throw for NFL coaches and scouts. Kyle, who's your player to watch?
Okay, it's the mythical backup quarterback who just won a national championship. This guy who's played in two games, and we're saying maybe a third-round pick? Come on, the hype is unreal.
Kyle, he did win a national championship.
Yes, he did. It was incredible. Peter, 8 quarters of football, third-round pick. Get out of here.
If he blows up the combine like some people expect, he could be a first-round draft
pick. No, Nate, no way.
Listen, this isn't a particularly strong draft class for the quarterback position. And you know when that happens, teams get desperate for that QB, and they start to reach a little bit.
Guess we'll find out soon.
Yes, I hear you, and I've been hearing you for the last 15 minutes. I'm on top of it. How many times do you need to... Yes, I'm on top of it. I'm meeting with... I've got a few other guys to meet this week, and then... I know that there's a time restraint. I understand that.
Thanks for taking the time to meet me.
Yes. Well, I know what he wants. I understand what he wants. He's told me what he wants. You don't have to tell me what he wants as well, okay?
Okay.
Just, can you hold on for a second?
Okay, but
thank
I don't
you.
Have a long
no,
time.
Just be quiet. I take any of the other top quarterbacks available, and I get praise, and I get to keep my job. I pick you, a player that barely even picked up a ball in college, and then I'm nuts. And the seat that I've got to sit on gets red hot. So why don't you tell me why you should even be on my radar?
I just won a national championship. And that's not the last trophy I plan to have on my mantle. You pick me, you better clear your shelf for some hardware.
Hey, I'm gonna have to call you back.
Call me back, but...
Yes, I'll have to call you back.
Hey, okay. I love you.
I love you too, Dad.
Bye.
Are you for real? You and I have a mutual friend in common, Mr. Jack Ford. He and I served on the same staff in St. Louis together. What do you think he might say about your ability to lead a locker room?
Look, I respect Jack Ford, and I want you to...
Let me just stop you right there. Jack had nothing but praise to say about you. And frankly, now, so do I. Listen, the truth is, my owner, he wants someone with the measurables. You go out there and you impress, and you will be on our radar. Can you do that?
Yeah. Sounds good.
Drink an extra protein shake, or whatever you gotta do.
Okay.
Hand over your phone. I want to check your internet history.
You want me to give you my phone? Is that just, like, normal procedure?
You bet it is. You just give anyone your phone? If someone asked for your playbook, would you give them that too?
No? What?
You have something to hide? Look, son, this interview's about transparency.
I think I'm being quite transparent.
Not transparent enough.
You're on a mountain in Alaska on a bus going 100 miles an hour. Where are you sitting on the bus?
Bus in Alaska. Well, back of the bus.
Back of the bus? Why?
I can help people escape out the back.
Are leaders in the front of the bus, the middle of the bus, or the back of the bus?
Leaders are where they need to be.
Interesting answer.
I figure back of the bus... Saving people makes me look selfless. It shows that I'm a team player.
Good answer. The correct answer should have been wherever I'm needed.
Funny how many eyes are on us right now, huh? Breaking us down, picking us apart. Every mistake amplified. But we got it though, right? At least I know I do.
Hey, I'm looking for your agent.
I don't have an agent.
Didn't have an agent. Lesmore, congratulations.
For what?
For getting an agent. Me. Boom.
I don't think... Have I met you before?
You're about to know me.
Quarterbacks, group four.
Looks like you're up to throw, kid. Go get him. Or should I say, go get him, client? You,
No, I'm good, man, yeah.
Yeah.
That's good.
Got a lot of people already. Full roster. Too full.
Ready!
New York fans were very vocal about you this week on social media. How would you feel about playing for the Giant?
Well, they're right. This is a team that needs a leader. And they know I can be the guy for them.
Very true.
What do you feel is your biggest strength as an NFL quarterback?
Well, I pride myself in my ability to get the job done. I'm able to focus and perform under pressure, and I think you guys saw that in the college playoff.
You definitely did.
What do you say to the critics that think you aren't ready to play in the NFL?
Well, they're right. I have a lot of work to do. I'm focused on getting better every day.
Let's say this all doesn't work out for you. What's your plan B?
No plan B for me.
That's a great answer.
Very smart. Thank you.
Bavarian chocolate cake. Nice twist. That's my client. Let it go to voicemail. Build some anticipation. But if you answer it, you'll show that the teams can count on you. So? Answer it. Hello?
Congratulations. You're one of the select few players invited to this year's NFL draft in Nashville. Please have your agent contact our office, and we'll see you in the Music City in April.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Yes! Oh, sorry. Wait. What are you gonna wear?
I never even thought about that.
Come on, Les. Think. What is he gonna wear? A suit.
I don't have a suit.
We can purchase one.
Okay. Give me good.
On me.
Get this guy out, huh?
It's
a winner right there. Yeah. Come on, give him a turn. Give him a spin. That's it. Yeah, drink it all in.
Will you wear it?
It's okay, you don't have to do that. It's okay.
I don't think I have to do that.
Okay, right.
Give me the over-shoulder look.
There he is.
Look right here. Looking good, man. Look my way. Hey, my way.
What's going on?
Oh, just you, please.
Yep, yeah, no. Take it all in. Yeah. Yeah.
Get right there, Richie. Don't move, don't move.
We need a window. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. Hey, this guy. How are you?
2019 National Football League Draft Live on NFL Network, an amazing spectacle right here in Nashville, Tennessee, that has been filled with intrigue and drama, and it is all about to suddenly subside with answers to long-standing questions involving the Heisman Trophy winner, Kyler Murray. DJ, you're first. What are you expecting to see tonight?
Well, I'm just waiting for this first pick, not knowing what's going to happen with the first pick and Kyler Murray specifically. That, to me, is the biggest story in this entire draft.
And for me, over the last few years, it's been about movement to get quarterbacks. You know, I'm looking to see, is there going to be some movement? Are people going to start jumping? From Hollywood Brown and Cody Ford.
Six picks left in the first round. Can't afford my condo representing a second rounder. Sorry. I need more clients. Signaling here. Stinks. Hey, anybody know how much a 26th pick makes? No? If that's the bank calling about my condo loan, tell them I'm not here. Just...
Hello?
Hey, this is Brian Flores, head coach of the Miami Dolphins. We've had our eye on you for a while. We're excited. We're going to make you the newest member of the Miami Dolphins. You ready to go on that?
Coach, I'm ready to make 25 other teams regret their decision.
Good, that's what I like to hear. Welcome to the Miami Dolphins.
Thank you.
Come on!
It's coming up here.
He hesitates a little bit. Look at the timing of that throw. On the money. Doesn't have to throw it 40 yards down the field. Yeah. Put it on the money, and you get a big play.
Here we go. Here's the commissioner with effect.
Oh! Players only.
In the 2019 NFL draft, the Miami Dolphins select...
Let's start at the top with the Dolphins. Draft winners or draft losers?
Losers.
How could you call them losers?
They filled the need at quarterback. It's great. They filled the need. They got a quarterback. Yay! And they spent a first-round pick on a six-round talent. That's a winner?
Six-round talent? Did you watch this dude play?
Yeah!
Did you see him at the combine?
Thank you.
Are you serious? He's been jumping up the draft boards for months.
Yeah, I watched him sit on the sideline in college. He couldn't even start for his college team. He's going to save an NFL franchise. Sure
yes,
he is.
And I'll tell you why. This isn't college. For the first time in his life, he actually has a coaching staff who is putting their faith in him. A coaching staff that actually believes in him.
So where are we headed?
Oh, isn't it on the app?
That you?
Yeah.
You know, I wasn't gonna say anything because I'm a professional. But for what it's worth, I think you are the guy that's gonna turn things around here for our quarterback situation. You know, I played a little JUCO ball myself.
That's cool, man. That's cool.
Had the coach in here last week, and I was not impressed at all. I do a little JV coaching in my spare time, so I have a really good feel about the game. Should have told him one of my plays. He could have used it this Sunday.
No, actually, I haven't even met him yet.
Coach Flores? He called defensive plays up in New England last year. But I'm a little worried about our offense. No offense. We lost Tannehill, Danny Amendola, the old workhorse, Frank Gore. They're all gone. You know that our best receiver is our running back. I get why they drafted you even after taking Rosen, because I think you could be the next Marino. And if the coaches don't see that, tell them to call me. I'll tell them.
Thanks. I'll pass it along. I'm not really sure how much they'll listen to me, though. I'm just a rookie.
Had Chris Pratt in here last week. Good-looking guy. I think if he fights a Raptor, the Raptor's gonna win. That's just me. That's just me. I don't care how many names he calls me. In fact, I actually did some... I do some archaeology on the side. And I found a T-Rex bone in Missouri once. I think it was a T-Rex bone.
I was like, look at... Whoa!
Sorry about that.
Cool, cool, cool. Actually, I think you just dropped me off right up here, man.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Just right up front. Thank you.
This is the start of something beautiful, kid. And in this city, if you need anything, if you need alpacas, if you need emus, any type of livestock, home loan, or warranty, you call me.
You're the guy.
If you... I think we'll call.
This game, it's about legacy, kid. Achievement. Exceeding expectations. Your college accolades, they're in the past. Your draft status, just a number. But your legacy, you start building that today. It's about the way you interact with teammates, coaches, opponents. It's about fearlessness, week in, week out. Overcoming the onslaught of the league's top defenders. demonstrating leadership in everything you do, from how you play to what you wear. It's about laying a strong foundation in your rookie season, becoming the quarterback I always knew you were. At first, right now, it's about winning the starting job. Good luck out there, kid.
Start your week by installing your game plan.
Oh, they asking my name, huh?
You ready?
S-T-R-O, I ain't come to play with you. Yeah. Life challenging, but I wouldn't trade with you. Trade. It's early, I'm up.
Yeah.
I can't spend the day with you. I'm minding my business. I ain't getting paid with you.
Nope.
My color bright.
Yeah.
I ain't finna fade with you. Man, I gotta come clean like I'm made with you. I've been on my everybody drop when I drop.
Yeah.
Look at shorty, she support, bro. Lifting up. Never not on my grind. New York City time. Another brother better, you will never find. I've been in my bag like groceries. Competition shouldn't take shots, take notes, please. Reporting live from the winner's side. Ready to try, keep a different vibe. Is you down the ride, never tired. You will never know, you ain't never tried. Work it out, hit the gym, hit the field. Hey, yo, I need that. Big chips, man, I need that. Hustle hard, on the job, you can see that. On my head is real good, we don't need your feedback.
Eat his aptitudes, talking trophies, I didn't grab the few, can't match this attitude. I went-